along to the Wizard Magic Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, we are back from Blackpool.
We are.
Finally in a physical state to do a show. More about that in a moment. But yeah, we're back from Blackpool. So this is a show where we're going to look at some of the things we bought back from Blackpool, talk about a couple of things that people were buzzing about. But I've got to tell you, Blackpool was not the best for me this year. After looking forward to it for a couple of years, if you came to see me on the dealer stand and I was kind of walking like this and moving like this, even having trouble picking up a box of liquid forks, it was because on the night before Blackpool started, I was in the restaurant. You were there, Paul Rothman,
yeah, Paul Rothman
from the Magic Of podcast was there. And we were sat having some dinner, and I went to the toilet, and I slipped on the stairs, fell down the stairs, and fractured two ribs in my back.
Spectacular style, with like both legs in the air, coming down flat on his back.
Bang! It winded me, couldn't speak for a while, and the next few days at Blackpool were very challenging to be on the dealer stand. Especially if you needed to laugh, and there's a lot of people that make you laugh at Blackpool, and there is a lot of people that tell you things that make you chuckle and that kind of thing. Every single time that happened, a little cough like that would be excruciating for me.
Yeah.
And if I sneezed, oh my goodness, for the last
the
2 weeks.
The amount of painkillers he was taking as well.
Yeah, thanks to Dave Bonsall that gave me some advice because he'd gone through some back trouble. And also Paul Martin that lent me a back support that's literally saved my life during the convention.
I honestly thought we were on our way up to the hospital and he was going home.
It was great. Really, and I do not remember the name of this guy, mainly because I was out of it on some painkillers. But there was a gentleman that came along to the dealer stand. Please send me a message and keep in touch. But he, like said, I'm a fracture specialist from Europe. This is what I do. Would you like me to examine you? And he took me around the back of where our stand was and he looked at it and said, yeah, it's probably this, probably that. Advised me on the medication to get over the counter. He even went to Boots and bought me the right sort of gels and heat spray and the right sort of stuff I needed to take care of. So keep in touch. Please send me a message. I'd love to stay in touch with you. And it just shows how wonderful the magic community is. Because I got through Blackpool.
We rallied
Blackpool for you. We teased it on the Wizard Magic Review last time. You had a couple of new specials.
It.
You had the knockout prediction too. And also, you sold out by the start of Sunday, your stretch coin.
Stretch coin, yeah.
Which is an Instagram...
Thank you, all of you.
An Instagram magician's dream, as proven by Magic Singh.
He surprised me, put it up on his video a couple of days after Blackpool. So yeah, it's a stretch coin. You can use it as a stretch bottle cap, a stretch spoon.
Well, when you first thought of it, you were showing it like a stretch spoon, a stretch coin. You can literally stretch anything metal.
It is a gimmick,
can't you?
Basically, it will stretch anything metallic.
Yeah,
so,
it really is very cool gimmick. And you were just doing it for people, and people saying, I'll have that, I'll have that, I'll have that, all day long. And it didn't take long for the man to completely sell out of those. But you're back in stock now.
Yeah, got back in stock now.
They are now on the website.
Yeah.
I must mention as well, parish notices for this month. I will be lecturing on the 16th of March at the Leicester Magicians Network. I'll put some posts on my normal Facebook page. It is a public post, so anybody can see it, even if you're not a friend. And it's £5 for guest magicians at the Railway Institute, I think it's called. That is on the 16th of March this month, £5 for guest magicians in Leicester, which is bang centre of the country. Mm. But we're going to talk about some of the new releases that we actually bought. Did you buy some stuff at Blackpool?
I bought a couple of things, yeah. Got some coins.
You did buy a couple of things, didn't you?
I did buy a couple of things.
You bought some coins and
some artwork.
And some stuff from Luke, which we'll talk about in a bit.
Yeah, I got some stuff from Luke, yeah.
And some coins.
And some coins. And I got some artwork.
Some lovely artwork.
Yeah, I did get some artwork.
And he's looking a bit sheepish, is the man, Mr. Fox.
Because I know what you've done. Because I know what you're going to do.
Because it was Thursday night, before I'd fallen down the stairs, when we were in a happier mood. And I caught Mr. Fox on camera saying this.
How much are you going to spend on magic, Wayne?
Spending any money on magic? Nothing.
No money or magic.
And it didn't quite work out that way, did it? And I knew when you said, I'm not buying anything this year, I said, right, I'm going to video you and I'm going to put that on the show the moment you part with money.
I part with your money.
This is one of the products that we actually brought back. This is Gentleman's Magic produced this. And I think one of the reasons that I actually went and bought this was because of my sort of broken back, my broken ribs. I couldn't actually look around too much to the left. I couldn't look too much to the right. But where we were on the balcony,
it was right there.
I could see these banners advertising their products, and they were straight ahead of us in the middle of the dealer hall.
Yeah.
So I think that's why I was drawn to this, as well as the iTunes that I also picked up, which we'll show in a moment. But this is Bottle. It's by Gentleman's Magic, but it's an invention of Michael Chatelain, and it is €45, and it was £40 at Blackpool.
Lovely packaging as well.
Yeah, you said before it's like an apple
style. Like apple packaging, yeah.
And you get the link in there as well, how to actually do it. But the way I thought you could present it, there's about a 30-minute tutorial that comes with it. The 30-minute tutorial goes over lots of different handlings. You could do it with a signed coin if you wanted to. But I just thought it was nice to be able to do it like this, which is to get it examined. So first of all, you can examine the cork, Wayne. Examine the cork, make sure it's okay.
It is just a cork.
It is just a cork, and that can be examined. And that goes in the bottle like that and seals the bottle, because that's the only way into the bottle. You can check out the bottle as well.
Check out the bottle.
And is the bottle?
It is a glass bottle, and it's only got one hole in it.
It's like a jam jar bottle.
Yeah, it's like that, yeah.
It's a little bit smaller. And we're also going to need some coins as well. Let's get two different size coins, a 10 and a penny. Wayne, choose any one of those. Choose
any 10 pence.
The 10p. We're going to do it with the 10p, but just to start with, that is the only way into the bottle.
Yeah.
So the penny goes into the bottle like this,
it
and
is.
I'm going to seal it with the cork. So now that is sealed inside the bottle.
Yeah.
You've examined the cork, you've examined the bottle.
And the bottle.
And you chose the 10p to do the trick with, right?
Yeah.
I want you to hold my wrist here, Wayne. Hold my wrist.
Okay.
There we go. And we'll try and do this on camera.
All right, go on.
Get as close as I can to the close-up camera, and you should see this happen. Watch the bottle, watch the 10p. It's going to happen in 3, 2. Check it out, look. Right in the centre.
It is so good, mate.
It is
the
incredible.
The visuals are so good.
The coin literally penetrates straight in to the glass bottle like that.
Mm.
And I don't want to say too much about what you get, but there is a gimmick. The gimmick is there. I'm sure knowledgeable magicians know what went on there, can see how you can present that. But it is a very nice gimmick. And it was one of the things that when I was looking around at Blackpool, when you're looking for something different and you see things demonstrated by the guys on the dealer stand, because some people get a bit funny when they see me and then I say, can you show me your trick? And they go, no. Get a little bit scared.
That
happened a couple of times, but we love watching magic, don't we? But people do get scared demonstrating things for us. But
don't have to.
No, because we love watching magic. And when we see something good with a great gimmick, a great invention like this, we will invariably pick it up because we love having bits of magic. And you said you were going to get this because it's something that you just wanted on the house, on the side.
It's something that, for me, this is something that is just curious. Sitting on a shelf with a little, you know, in one of those little, making a thing of it, a display cabinet, you could intertwine some kind of story with it and just have that up there with two coins sitting on the side until somebody says, what are all these things in these cupboards? And you've got like a little magic show in the corner of your room. I love stuff like that.
And the great thing is, I'm just showing this carefully on camera now. It really is very, very well made.
Yeah, you would not know.
You're not going to be able to see anything. And yet, the moment that that cork goes in there,
that's
you
it.
Are set up to do the effect. It reminds me of the corker which was out many years ago for like coin in bottle. Mm. But this means that you can use a larger regular coin. Like I said, 30 minute tutorial that goes into it, tells you a few things that you can do with it. But most of the time you're just gonna go, look, an empty jar, there's
you
a
really
coin.
Are. Yeah.
And it really does look impossible how the coin gets inside the jar. So that's bottle from Gentleman's Magic, €45 or £40. I recommend it if you've got a use for it. So before we tell you about the next thing that we bought back from Blackpool, it is again something that both of us got, having seen it at Blackpool, we want to mention the Workers' Award. So the last Workers' Award went to R-Digit, which is something that it's part of my everyday carry
love
now.
It. All the
I
time.
Take it with me everywhere. It's like a full routine that you can do anywhere, especially as a tech magician. Mm. Just suits me perfectly. But the next Workers' Award is something that I absolutely love performing. I'll put some clips on the screen of me doing it. I do it now at every single wedding. I've even done it at like an evening party or something like that. I've performed it 3 or 4 times now, and it is absolutely fantastic. And it is from James Wang and Hanson Chen. It is sparkling. Sparkling, congratulations. You have got yourself a Workers' Award. Every single member of the Wizard Magic Review team agrees that this is definitely a worker. We've been out, we've tried it in the real world. The reactions are second to none. I've also bought some corks with no ink. They were on eBay, £10 for 100 corks, so I can actually give them away at the end of it as well. So it's an unbelievable souvenir. And what it's like a pyrotechnic at the end of a magic routine. It is absolutely fantastic. So sparkling is not only got a great review on the Wizard Magic Review, you've got yourself the coveted Workers' Award, which proves that we've tried it in the real world, and it is a fantastic effect. It is brilliant. We don't know if this is going to get a Workers' Award yet. We do love it, don't we?
We do love it.
Picked it up at Blackpool.
We do love it.
And it was something that caught my eye once again, because I couldn't see left, couldn't see right, but straight ahead there was the Gentleman's Magic stand, and they got a big banner and it said iToon, and it was a digital version of Card 2.
Yeah.
And this is an app that you can get, and I came back to the stand, showed it you straight away.
That was it.
And you were like, how much is that? £35, £50?
I did say that.
Yeah. $12.99 on
ridiculous.
The App Store. I presume it's like $15 or something like that if you're in America, but it's $12.99 English pounds. And this is iToon. We're going to try and do a little demonstration of it using the deck of cards. Wayne, do you think it's possible for a magician, a magic man, a sleight of hand artist? That's me, by the way. Do you believe it's possible for me to make you pick the card that I want you to pick? Say yes.
Yes.
It is true. I can do that.
Can you?
So if I offer you a card to take like that, don't do that. Don't do that. Because I could cheat. I could cheat. I could make you choose the card that I want you to choose.
You could do that.
Using skill. Sleight of hand and card forcing. Shouldn't mention that, but card forcing. As you go to take a card, I could slip another card into your fingertip. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to spread the cards like this. They are all different. I'll spread the cards. Just reach in, just grab any card you want.
I've just grabbed any card I want.
Have you got one?
Yeah.
Please remember that card.
I'm remembering it.
Okay, now I'm going to flick through at the corner.
Do you want me to show
this.
The camera?
Yeah, show the camera.
So do I.
Yeah, go on. Do that. Have you done it?
Yeah.
We're getting confused who's presenting it now. There we go. I'll flick through. Say stop.
Where stop.
Do you want to go one more?
No.
Normally they go one more.
One more.
You do want to go one
yeah.
more?
Yeah.
You don't need to.
All right, leave it.
You sure?
Stop bullying me.
I'll separate them there. Put the card back right there. Was that fair?
Yeah.
No, it's not fair. It's not fair. No, it's cycle. It's the way you think.
Right.
You see, when you were going through the cards, you were drawn towards a certain card. What star sign are you?
Virgo.
Virgo. I don't believe in the stars, but that's typical of an Aries. It is weird because you were drawn towards a certain card, and that's because as you look through the cards, you probably didn't realise this, but certain cards tend to stick out from the crowd. Mm-hmm. Even though you took out one card, why did you pick the Ace of Spades? I don't know why you picked that card. Why did you pick that card? I don't know.
Why did I pick it?
Take the pen.
I'll take
Can
the
you
pen.
Write your name on the Ace of Spades? just there. That's cool. Recapping the pen as well. You're a professional. Can you hold out your hand? Flat. Can you put your other hand on top? I'll tell you what. No, sit on it. Actually, sit on the card. That's great. Sit on it. And I'm going to flick through and let's get you to look at another card. So say stop.
Stop.
Just there. Can you remember that one?
Yeah.
Remember that one? Remember that one. Got it? Do not forget it. But I'm not going to find the card this time.
Mm-hmm.
I am not going to find the card. A friend of mine is going to find the card. And he is inside the card box. Give the card box a little shake and see if you can hear him inside. Can you hear him inside the card box?
A little tiny bit.
Can you hear him?
No.
He's inside the card box, but he only exists in the digital world. So to see him in the digital world, just make sure we can see this on camera, I am going to use my phone. And let's see if we can see him in the digital world. This is a live shot, so if you move your hand behind that way, and just move your hand, there you go. You can see this is a live shot.
There I am.
And let's see if we can do this right now. There he is, look. Come on. He comes out of the card case. He takes off his top hat. And he's looking for your card right now.
He's looking for it.
And he's got the card. Hang on. Oh, he's got a rabbit. And he's got one card. He's folding it up. And he's thrown that folded card over towards my phone. You can actually see that inside the phone. But if I go 3, 2, 1, I can actually take out the card. What card did you just see, Wayne?
Five of hearts.
If this was the five of hearts, that'd be a great trick.
Yeah.
If it was the ace of spades with your name on, that would be incredible, because that's the one you're sat on.
Get off.
The five of hearts. Dun, dun, dun.
It is brilliant.
It's nice, isn't it? So it works with augmented reality. As you saw then, and we don't want to film it again, it's good to show you what actually happens. If you've got to get the lighting right and hold your phone nice and steady and as close to it as possible, otherwise the animation kind of stops and starts. Another thing you can do, which they do suggest on the download, is to draw like a circle around this part here so the augmented reality picks up on it a little bit more. I would rather not have the circle on there if possible. And if you use the plain bicycle card back designs, when they shake it, that gives you the misdirection for what you need to do. It is an app, the lighting, it is a little bit temperamental, but if you draw the circle, makes it better. You can do a couple of different presentations. You can do that, which is the interactive mode, which allows you to pull out a card during the middle of a routine. Or you've got the standard, the classic presentation, which allows you in the action of unlocking your phone to allow the stick man to just appear in a theatre and just produce the card. It's like he just thinks of it and then the card is there. I don't think that's as good as the interactive mode and the card coming out of it. I think the fact that it combines card to phone and that kind of thing, I think it makes it really strong. I like the idea of Red Hot Mama and them sat on the card and it changing place.
Yeah, the combination of doing that is good. I must say, though, that I don't have a problem with drawing a circle on there. I actually quite like the idea of saying to them, let's make this into a doorway. Look, yeah. I'll just draw a door. It looks like a Hobbit's door in the Lord of the Rings as well, doesn't it?
Like Roddy McGee's little door.
Exactly, yeah. So you open it up and say, look, that's like a little door. Then you've got the perfect excuse for it to work.
Also, in the settings, you can change the settings. So when you're unlocking your phone, it all looks like your normal phone. And you can also use ESP symbols as well. And I'm sure they might update it over time as well as more people buy it. But I do think it's very good. I do think the animation is very, very cool. And it's one of my favourite things that we brought back from Blackpool.
It really is. Very, very good. Next, though, Dave. Next. Old friend of mine, Luke Osland.
Luke Osland.
Yeah. He was a very outspoken little kid when I was lecturing for the Young Magicians Club at the Magic Circle. He was always up the front, sitting at the front, going, Wayne, I've got this brilliant idea with this. And he's, you know, it's a great kid, turned out to be a decent young man, and he's bringing out some decent magic along with this book, Visual AF Magic Tricks. We all know what that stands for.
Visual and Fantastic Magic Tricks.
That's what it is, Dave. Well done, mate. this is absolutely jam-packed full of ideas on the way you can create magic.
Yeah, I think he's worked as a consultant for some top TV magicians, Dynamo, and there's no surprise because he does create amazing magic for social media, especially, you know, magic that can be done in the real world as well, but especially visual magic that works very, very well on camera. And a lot of his effects in this book it's difficult to sort of tell you about the individual effects without giving away the material in the book. All I would say is if you're interested in visual AF magic tricks, especially for your social media, say you want to put up a certain amount in 1 month, this book will be something that will really interest you.
Yeah, pretty real.
That was a book that he had, and these are from visualmagicstore.com. I think they're available now from pretty much worldwide dealers, but we got this from Luke himself, so it's Visual Magic Store.
Thank you, Luke.
And this is Sweet Disposition, which was one of the tricks of Blackpool, I would say.
Yeah.
A lot of people pick this up at Blackpool.
Yeah. Should have
they must them. Have done, so I keep seeing it on social media.
It's all over the place.
You're going to do it. We're going to get a bit close up camera.
We're going to get a bit messy here, mate. We're going to get a little bit messy. A little bit of sugar down there as well. Can you see all the granules are all individual?
Yeah.
However, if I rub the granules,
ooh,
it's just a matter of time that you can see.
That does look very, very good.
They just melt together until it ends up with one little sugar lump.
That does look brilliant. That really does look good. And it's as if, like you said earlier when you were doing it, the granule by granule, it's like they're moulding together
exactly.
In front of their eyes.
It does look like it. It's a little visual feast for the eyes that's happening in the palm of your hand. I really enjoy this, along with so many other magicians already.
So I've forgotten how much the book is, but that is £17, isn't it?
£17, yeah.
From Visual Magic Store. You get two gimmicks as well with it in the packet and the link. For it's like a 30-minute tutorial on how to do the effect, and Luke takes you through it. And there's a bonus effect as well at the end.
Brilliant little trick.
It's a really great effect. It's visual AF magic, and that definitely is. And I think it's one of the tricks of Blackpool. It's really good value, available from visualmagicstore.com. And now it's special guest time. So here's something else I brought back from Blackpool.
I wish you had. It would have saved me some money on the petrol.
Oh, don't get me started about fuel prices. Matthew Garrett launched at Blackpool his incredible new version of the Ninja Plus linking ring. It's like an add-on
to the
already amazing. Right, you are the god of close-up linking rings, as far as I'm concerned. I could watch him do this all day. It is incredible. It's the routine that you did, part of the routine you did when you won the Magic Circle Close-Up Magician of the Year.
Forms Ninja Plus back in 2010, that was, yeah.
Wow. You are the master, but I got a sneak preview of this. We were at the Magic Circle just before the convention. You said, I'm going to show you what I'm bringing out. And there's a bit where you kind of think to yourself, oh, it's going to be linking rings. And then there was a point where I went, hang on a minute, I know how linking rings works. This is just mind-blowing, and it is unbelievable what you've brought to it.
Thank you.
I'm hoping you can demonstrate it.
Yes, absolutely. But
you can tell us about the history, how it came about. The stage is yours. This is one of the best things I saw at Blackpool.
Thank you very much. Well, I'm going to start off in a way that's going to be familiar with a lot of magicians, and it starts off in the same way as normal, but there's a point where you're going to see something different.
Right.
So we're going to start off with 1, 2, 3, 4 rings. And everything I like to do, I like to be very precise. So it's right here it's going to go through, David. 1, 2, just on 3. Passes straight the way through. From the front.
That didn't pass through. That melted through. That was like Terminator 2. It just went through the bars. It's like the Terminator. You know.
I like to keep the frame in tight. So from the front, it looks like it's linked from the front. I say from the front because if I hold the ring sideways, You can see that they're not really linked at all. Now, perhaps you'd do me a favour. I'm going to get you to hold on to one of the hoops. Hold on here.
Right.
This way you can feel it solid, and it still goes, and you can just check, just make sure that there's no gaps, no breaks. We're still on familiar ground at the moment for magicians.
This isn't even the new bit.
This isn't the new bit.
It still looks incredible, this
So, bit. It's here. One, two, just by three. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking there has to be a soft spot, right?
Yeah.
There is a soft spot. Do you know where it is?
There. No, where you're holding
just
it.
Here, just here. I'm going to join it here, not near my hand. I'll join it out here in the open. I want to see precisely where it goes. Round about there. One by one, the hoops disconnect. So there goes the first one. That'll be the second one. I do my own sound effect. There's three. There's four. So that's the end of a normal-ish routine?
Yeah.
Now let's take it a stage further. No gaps, no breaks. And the idea is to try and connect. So just watch right here. If I click, it goes straight the way through. And there really are no gaps.
What?
Now we take this further. So whenever you're performing routines, because magicians do this, we perform, and every magician hates this idea that someone's going to tell you to move your hand out of the way and you can't. And I love the bits where you really can and you get this nice, just examine. And I like the bits where you have to immediately join rings, pass them out for examination, immediately disconnect them, and instantly they're out for examination again. And of course, they're not going to find anything because there genuinely are no gaps.
And I don't drink, but at the Magic Circle, I got to this point and I was thinking, have I been drinking? Has somebody spiked my drink or something?
Well, it catches magicians off guard because they expect a normal link again and then you're doing something different. And it catches lay audiences off guard in the same way. So if you've got that awkward spectator who's going to try and catch you out with this effect, you just use it whenever you like.
You can do it right at the start.
Oh, you can do it whenever you like. You can start the whole routine with it and it's just, there's no gaps, there's no breaks. We'll go again. So I really do want you to see. I'm going to be as fair as I can about the whole process. No gaps, no breaks. And let's create a display here. I'll hold it up. Just one by one they disconnect. One, two, three.
Oh, that's so good.
Or four rings. I like the fact I wanted the routine so that you could have the rings examined before you start, in the middle and at the end. And that's exactly what you can do with this. See the display we've got here?
Yeah.
I don't know if I can hold it up.
Like a Charles Atlas type thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
An atlas, a globe. When I do a parlour show, I actually leave this on display because then I can go and I can pick it up and start the routine. So it's going to stop anyone who's going to say things to you like, the rings have got a soft spot in them. You just have this lovely display with them sitting on the side. So that's another sort of way of using it. And I like the fact you can combine more in it with the routine as well. So if I can show you Ninja Plus as well.
So just to be clear, GIR is the element, the new element that allows you to start super clean, go into the routine whenever you want, or during Ninja Plus you could introduce GIR.
Absolutely.
And kill any awkward spectators dead or magicians that think they know what's going on after 2,000 years.
Very, very versatile it is. So in the set, you get, your online instructions. I also have a DVD as well, and it's a two DVD set.
I do want to see Ninja Plus as well.
Yeah, I won't forget. I will show you as well. So I know some people still use the old-fashioned DVDs. I think you call them old-fashioned now.
Yeah.
But we've got the quick start guide, so it teaches you your normal four rings routine. And in addition, you get the extra two rings to do the GIR. So there's six rings that you get in a set, and they come presented in a box.
I know you have students and you do personal tuition as well with people. How long does it take for somebody that's got sort of magical ability, they do magic, to start? And how steep's the learning curve with it?
I was getting people to perform this at the stand. So the unlinked that you were doing, that you saw me do, where it's crystal clear and you unlink it, I was getting people to perform that at the stand.
That's GIR. And Ninja Plus, if you wanted to dedicate some time to that.
So I like all of the routines in that you can be performing them straight away. I qualified, as you probably know, as a teacher before I did magic. Yep. So when I do my instructional videos, I like them to be crystal clear. Start off with a very simple routine so you can be outperforming by the next day. And then you build on the knowledge and you can learn more and more. Should we do Ninja Plus as well?
Yeah, do Ninja Plus
as
well.
So this is a separate effect. So far up to now, you've just seen GIR. And it's available in, we've got the gold finish here.
Mention the website as well.
Yep, so the website is ninjaplus.co.uk. So ninja, and then plus.co.uk.
No worries.
These are available in silver finish, which are your traditional finish, nice shiny silver. Also in the gold, so nice shiny gold. People ask what the plating's like. It doesn't wear. You know, I've spent a long time doing these to make sure that the finish is correct.
Yeah.
There's no welds visible. Everything.
Well,
they're
the best one. They're the best quality close-up linking rings by far.
Thank you. That was my requirement. I wanted them to be, because when I hand items out, that's representing me. Yeah. It's. I wanted the best. And also in the chrome black, you called these sort of like a gun finish.
Gun metal.
I really like the finish that we've got on these. So that's the finish on there. So, yeah, it's a different type of finish. So, yeah, three choices to have as a finish for them. Ninja Plus.
Do it.
So we start off, and you can do, I love the thing with rings, is that you can do any coin moves that you like. So often before I start the routines, I might do things with the rings that are jumping around. Yeah. So I always think any coin workers, just straight away you can do everything that you do with coins, you can bring it into the Ninja Plus routine. Now I'm going to get you to hold out your hand nice and flat like a little table for me, please, David. We'll rest that down on there. And we'll take the big hoop. It's just around here. Just go straight the way through. Just feel it, just make sure it really is on.
That looked unbelievable.
Okay, we'll move your hand away for the moment. We're happy that that definitely is joined.
Oh, it's on there.
Because a lot of people think it's not, you see. Let's go again.
Crikey,
what I do is
amazing.
I give it three taps. One, two, it's the third time. Did you see it go? It just jumps from hoop to hoop. Comes off. And just check that. Really do just make sure there's no breaks. There's no breaks. I like the versatility.
I'm so pleased I've seen this before, because it'd be too much to take.
two different methods at one time. Yeah.
This, I know about this one because I've seen it before, but it would have been just too much. You would have.
For me, it's just that thing with the rings. It can be one ring joins to another ring, and for me, I like mixing the methods up. I think that makes it so confusing, so no one's going to chase you and guess how it's done. And the thing the finger ring does,
the
it just provides that other dimension, doesn't it? And I do a lot with borrowed rings as well, as
beautiful.
A matter of fact. Thank you very much. Now watch the centre, David. Do you notice the change there?
Yeah.
Because it was up here, wasn't it? Now it moves down, and we're just going to move it from one hoop straight the way through to the other. The large rings just melt through like that. The fingering here, it's a little flick, it comes off. But just remember, I should always keep that safe on my finger.
Unbelievable.
So that's Ninja Plus. I should probably talk more about GIR as well. So I think we're always on the shoulders of giants, aren't we? So with something like the linking rings, it's got this long history. I watched Levent. He does a great DVD set, a four DVD set, where he talks about the history of the linking rings. And I was watching this idea from the 1930s of Fitzkey and Hilliard. And they use these stage rings. And there's a certain method they use that I thought, wouldn't it be great if you could somehow adapt that and use it in close-up? So I've made a few important changes. So rather than just be a stage piece, it's close-up and it's examinable. And that for me was really important. So that's how it all came about. And on the DVD, I've teamed up, it's not just me on here. I teamed up with two Norwegian magicians, with Mike Hill and Brian Huset, who are experts at the rings anyway. One of them's training to do his FISM performance with car manipulations and things as well. The other one's been on a finalist on Norway's Got Talent. So They can do magic tricks, they're great guys. But the nice thing is, their routines are entirely different than mine. So what you've got on here, my work is very detailed. So you've got routines that you can do where, like I just showed you, a nice simple routine of using your normal four ring set and introducing GIR. There are three ring sets, four ring routines, five ring, some that use all just the GIR rings. So there's a complete mixture across. They've got very different performing styles. So Mike Hill uses a lot of flourishy moves, which brings another dimension through. There's a lot of work on the globe that Brian Huset does as well. So there really is there's tons of stuff on the DVD. It's like you learn all the routine. Whenever I say the length, because it's over 2 hours, whenever I say the length, I like to point out to people, you learn the routine in the first half an hour. And after that, it's just playtime, move after move and different routines. And that's what I like about it, the versatility of what you can do with this.
So if you want any more details on this package or what Matthew launched at Blackpool, the whole sort of special deal, say people wanted to, they just went, right, all in, I want to do everything that I've done, that they've seen today. the start bit with GIR going into Ninja Plus. What would that be? Would that be three sets altogether?
Package deal one.
Package deal one, there we go.
Yeah, if you go on the website, I do have package deals. So people can choose if they want your normal Ninja Ring set with Ninja Plus. I personally think GIR and Ninja Plus is what I would advise people to get, because then you can do everything.
Say the website again.
ninjaplus.co.uk. So that's the word ninja, followed by plus.co.uk.
We'll put it on the screen as well. And obviously, each individual set, if you go from that website, is checked by you personally. They get product support from you personally. And absolutely. I know you're very good at sort of interacting with people and answering any questions they've got, because you are literally...
This is my thing. This is my you know, reputation on the line. This is what I've spent over the last 10 years developing and working on. I love it. And for me, it's a whole game. It's interesting. Different performers have different styles. Masado's very much into the flourishes.
Yeah.
For me, I'm into this whole game of the audience chasing you. Is there a gap? Isn't there a gap? Is there a catch? Isn't there a catch?
I love it.
And I like the whole game and playing and different objects coming into play. And that, for me, is my thing with the rings.
Yeah, it's absolutely incredible. Congratulations. I didn't think the linking rings was ever going to be taken further than it has been before by you and everything else that you brought out, especially Ninja Plus. That was groundbreaking. But GIR is absolutely incredible. Visit the website, check it out. Definitely one of the best things we saw at Blackpool, wasn't it, Blammo?
Thank you, Blammo.
Finally this week, this is another thing we brought back from Blackpool. It is Infinity Wine. Infinity Wine by Magic Dream. And the price is €79, and refills are about €20. But we're going to demonstrate this right now. So you start with an empty wine glass, and the effect is, it's the stuff of miracles, Wayne.
This
you
really
take
is, Wayne.
Water, and you pour water into a glass. That does look incredible, doesn't it?
It does.
And before your very eyes, it does turn into wine. That looks incredible. And we're not messing around here. We followed the tutorial. It's about 30 minutes long. And
I can smell it already.
It smells like wine as well. And let's give it a go.
Yeah.
Genuinely, it tastes like wine. Because we're doing one of the little extras, which is suggested on the tutorial. But here's the intriguing thing. By the way, I'm driving later, so I'm going to save this for later.
Of course.
So you can pour that away. Keep it for later. That's good. Here's the intriguing thing. You've done it once. You can literally do it again. Straight away. And get another glass of wine.
It's just brilliant, mate, isn't it?
And it smells like wine.
No.
And it tastes like wine. It's incredible. And you can pour it away and save it for later. But that's not it, which makes it a perfect running gag for any show or anything like that. You could toast the audience, have a drink, do the next bit of magic. I'm definitely going to use this in my parlor.
Imagine that
show.
As an MC and you're trying to do a little speech.
It's
and
brilliant.
Pouring out water and you're pouring out glasses of wine over and over again. It does look impossible. It really does look like an impossible piece of magic and real magic.
It's almost like a very magical, very clean version of any drink called for. Imagine if you had pre-show or something like that, or just had a drink chosen by a spectator, and any drink for me to enjoy during the show, and still smells like wine and tastes like wine as well. It's incredible. And you could drink that during the show if you wanted to, and at any time go back to it. And it's just such a funny thing to keep refilling that.
I think it's brilliant.
It's amazing. The glass that you get with it is polycarbonate as well, so you don't have to worry about that smashing.
And it looks like glass, you know, it looks like a real glass, and that's the
I think it's worth the money. I think it's brilliant. The idea with the bottle, the funnel is all suggested on the tutorial.
The bit that got me was when you go and you carry on doing it.
Yeah.
I just thought it's going to be, it's just a one-off thing. Hang on a second, what's going on there?
Yeah, that's the bit where they think, hang on, that can't work. Mm. That can't happen. And I just think it's a great moment when you're having a drink. During the parlour show, I'm going to use this. Because I think it's a really great moment when you're having a drink with the audience. You just pause for a moment, you do the talking bit. And while you're doing the talking bit, you have a drink with the audience and you have a chat. And then you pour it away and say, sorry, I've got to remember, I'm driving. Mm. And then you go to the next talking bit and you get it and you get the water. And then you'd carry on talking for a while and there'd be a moment where the audience would be thinking, oh, hang on, he can't be going to do it again. He can't be, like you were thinking.
Yeah.
And then you just, like it's nothing, you just, and they'd be going, what? And you have a drink, you ask somebody in the audience a couple of questions, ask where they've travelled from, then you pour it away again into the bottle. What a great running gag, just to break up the magic. But also make the show feel more like a show, because it actually links bits together.
It does, yeah.
And by having a running gag or a running bit of magic, it actually sort of connects that whole show together. I think, of all the things I've brought back, that's probably my favourite, is Infinity Wine. I think that's the one. That's the one that I'm really going to treasure and use all the time. I'm looking forward to doing that. In the same way that I was looking forward to doing sparkling and it really paid off for me, I'm genuinely looking forward to doing that. Whereas everything else, they're good tricks, they're great tricks. I love the cartoon effects, the digital version. But that is just unbelievable for me.
Yeah, that there's a lot of legs in it. That's why. You know that if you're an MC, if you're just emceeing a wedding or it really is perfect,
and the gimmick's really good. It's really reliable. We've hardly tried it, we're already doing it on the show. It just kind of works.
It's not difficult, is it? Just does it itself.
It's
really
not difficult to set up at all. It really does look fantastic. And of all the things we brought back, I think that one is my favorite. That's Infinity Wine. Still got another few things that we did bring back, which will filter out onto the show over the next few weeks.
Yeah.
Because there were things that need to be sort of tried out a bit more. A really nice coining can, which I got, and a gimmick from Metal Writing as well, using a phone case.
Mm-hmm.
A few good things, but we'll filter those onto the Wizard Magic review in a few weeks' time. So if I bought something off you or Wayne bought something off you, don't worry if you didn't see it on the show this time, because we'll probably filter them onto the shows in the next few weeks.
Yeah.
But they were the ones, as well as our special guests, that we wanted to share with you today.
Those are the bits.
That's it for this week's Wizard Magic Review. Don't forget, come and see us come and see me at the Leicester Magicians Network on the 16th of March. If you're not a member of the club, they are looking for new members, but if you're not a member of that club, it is £5 for guest magicians. I will also be a guest at the Northamptonshire Magicians Club dinner, which is coming up. If you want to get tickets for that, you can go on the Northamptonshire Magicians Club dinner website. So I'll see you there if you're going to that one. And I'll also be at the British Magic Society dinner as well. Scott Penrose is getting honoured.
I'm
going to support Scott because Scott has built a lot of things for me privately and for my show, like my parlour show table.
Yeah.
And he's working on some other stuff at the moment. I do think he's a huge credit to the magic community. So I want to give him support on the evening. That'll be at the British Magic Society dinner. I think that's 25th of March. But a few of those are coming up. Hope to see you at those social events. Please come and say hi. And that's it this week for the Wizard Magic Review. Thank you so much for watching. We really appreciate every single one of you. We're sorry there's been a little bit of a break, but I have been in a little bit of pain. Until next time, I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
See you next time
on
the Wizard Magic Review.